Fear Zone, your channel of horror stories. Good evening everyone, and now we go to the story of today, which is the young Lucas, and this happened to him in the city of Teixeira de Freitas, which is in Brazil, and at that time that was in the year 2013, the young Lucas was just a teenager. And today I am going to talk about a mysterious case that happened to me. And it all starts like this. At that time, I lived with my parents in a rural neighborhood far from the city, and by my village had few houses on the streets, but also the families that lived near my house raised chickens and goats, and even oxen and horses, and this was a normal thing in my region. But one night, I was in the backyard of my house, feeding my dogs, and soon I saw a man passing through the woods near my house, but he was carrying a small goat in his arms. This guy didn't see me, but I stayed hidden just watching this man, but this suspect disappeared through the dark woods and disappeared. I didn't pay much attention to this, and stayed with my dogs for a while, but then, after feeding my dogs, I went back home to watch TV. Well, time went by, and when midnight came, I went to my room to sleep, and so, already in my bed, I went to close the window, and it was then, that I saw an animal caught in my fence, and soon I noticed that it was a goat, and possibly, it was the same animal that that guy is suspicious was carrying in his arms. It didn't take long, and this goat went through the wire fence and into the yard, and it looked like the goat was running away from something. But at that time, a strange animal came running by my fence, and as it was kind of dark in the place, you could see a little bit, and it was a kind of big animal, and it seemed to be a big dog, and this beast kept running back and forth around the fence, and for sure this animal was trying to get inside my place, to get that goat that came through the fence. So I took my slingshot and some marbles, and from my window I saw this strange beast trying to get through the fence wires. Then I put the first marble in my slingshot, and I shot this creature the first time, but I missed, and the animal didn't notice anything, but the second marble that I shot at this beast with my slingshot hit it right in the head, and at that time, it turned around, pulling its head out of my fence, and soon the creature ran to the bush roaring in pain. I was startled by those noises from this beast, and I was scared too, because I saw the beast's lighted eyes, which were not normal. I kept thinking that this creature was after that goat, and that it entered the house. I kept wondering what had happened, because I saw this goat in the arms of that strange man. The fact is, I was very frightened by this huge animal that appeared, and it could even be some supernatural creature. I kept looking out the window in my backyard, and as the animal that fairy disappeared, I went to sleep a little. But around 4 o'clock in the morning, I heard my dogs barking, but they seemed very scared, and continued barking, so I got out of bed, and went to the living room, and looked out the window, and saw something near the fence, but it seemed to be a man. So, I turned on the light bulb in my yard, and got a big scare, seeing what was this figure, that seemed to be a bizarre creature, with the head of a man, and its ears were big like a dog's, and its face was all furry, and its eyes were lit up, and for sure, it was the same animal, that I shot with a slingshot at the fence the other time. But now this creature was standing on only two legs, and looking at my property, and to me, it was pretty clear that it was a werewolf, this monster, but luckily, with the lamp I lit my yard, this beast became suspicious, and then this werewolf stood on four legs, and ran into the underbrush and disappeared. With this, I was already in shock, to see this creature, and very worried, because this werewolf could try again to enter my land. Well, at this point, I was thinking of waking up my father, but I waited a little longer, and kept looking out the window, to see if the werewolf would appear again. However, when 20 minutes passed, I saw a man walking through the woods, and with his hands on his face, as if something was bothering him, and taking a closer look at the guy, it seemed to be the same guy, who was carrying the goat in his arms, at the very beginning of the night. Anyway, this guy passed by our house and left, and I was worried about this stranger, because of the werewolf that appeared. However, the day dawned, and I told this story to my father, and he knowing this, we went to see the goat that came into our yard, to see whose animal it was. My father told me that the goat belonged to one of his acquaintances, because this animal had a number mark on its skin, and my father told me to give it to the real owner. And what I did, is that I took the goat, then, I went walking, and taking the goat, and entered a path, and I was walking down the dirt road, but in the middle of the road, a man appeared. He said that the goat was his. I looked in this stranger, and realized that it was the same man, who passed by with a goat in his hands last night near home. I refused to give him the goat, and told him I would give it to the real owner, and this guy told me he bought it from a farmer who lived nearby, and I talked to him on the street. We arrived at the place called Sitio do Cabrito, where the man who owned several goats confirmed the story, that he had sold this animal to the stranger. Well, the strange guy got a kid. I noticed that his face was very swollen, and talked a little with this man. He asked me if I had seen some other kind of animal at dawn. I told the truth, and said I saw a werewolf, and my father was already knowing this story. I also said that I would get the gun from my father hidden in the next few nights, and I would stay in Campana, waiting for this werewolf appeared again, and if he came I would shoot to kill the creature. But, I was a bit suspicious with this man, because he seemed to be a very strange guy. I ended up not telling him anything, that I had seen him twice in the early morning near home. After this conversation, the guy ended up leaving. Amazingly enough, never saw this guy around my neighborhood until today. As time went by, the werewolf never appeared near my house. However, as some years went by, and I was getting older, with the years going by, and knowing things better, I started to relate that the guy who bought the goat, and who passed by my house twice at dawn, he could be the werewolf, yes, because he appeared around twice, before and after the werewolf appeared, and his swollen face, for sure was the slingshot that I hit the werewolf when he tried to enter my yard. And that was my account that I lived with this werewolf. Thanks for watching the video, and if you like it, leave your like and subscribe to the channel. Until the next scary story. Fear Zone, your channel of horror stories. And now, let's go to today's story, which is from Mr. Hernandez, and this happened to him in the city of Gravataí, which is in Brazil, and at that time, which was in the year 1996, Mr. Hernandez was 38 years old. And today, I will tell here, the day that the werewolf appeared on the road, and wanted to get me by any means. And it all starts like this. I live in an ordinary neighborhood in my city, and I live a normal life with my family. Once, I went by car with my wife and my son, to a family party of my uncle, who lived in the rural areas of the city, and there, I met some acquaintances and relatives. I stayed at this party until 2 o'clock in the morning, and after that, I got my car, and went back to my house. While I was driving by a dirt road, I passed a hole in the street, and my car as it was old broke down, and stopped on the road. This made me very nervous, but I had to get down to see the engine. Well, at least in this place, where I was, there was a small farm on this street. However, while I was checking the engine of my vehicle, something strange happened, and I got scared, because there was a horse leaning against the fence of the farm, and this animal neighed, and seemed very nervous about something. I found this animal strange, but I didn't pay much attention to it, and continued to tinker with the engine of my car. Before long, I heard some barking dogs coming from the farm, but I kept on working on the car, and after a while, my little son pressed the horn of the car, and it made a loud noise, and to my surprise, some kind of big strange animal ran out of the road, but I kind of realized that this beast was hiding in the woods, and it was going to attack me, but with the noise of the horn, it ran scared to the forest, and the impression I got that this beast was afraid of the noise of the horn. At that time, I was very frightened, but the beast disappeared into the darkness of the forest. At that moment, I started to push the car to start it, but while I was doing this, my wife suddenly shouted for me to get in the car. I got scared, and got in the car and closed the door quickly, and then I heard a noise on the car's body of something hitting the door very hard, and after this scare, I was even more afraid, because I saw the creature from the road surrounding my car, and he seemed to be very strange, because his head seemed to be human, but his snout was a dog, and this creature was very large, but what made me more terrified was his bright eyes, that for me, this beast was an evil being. Well, seeing that this beast wanted to attack us, I pressed the horn several times, and with noise the creature ran into the woods frightened, and with the fear that we were already passing, I stayed alert and looking at the forest on the side of the road. However, I didn't see this animal anymore, and of course, that creature could be hiding in the woods, waiting for me to get out of the car. So, not to take any chances, I pressed the horn a few more times, and this beast started to run through the woods, and he seemed to be annoyed by this noise of the car horn. After a while, I didn't see any sign of this creature, even though I pressed the horn. On this road no cars passed, then I heard some barking dogs, and then a man appeared near the farm fence, so I made a sign with my hands and asked that man for help, then the guy who was near the fence disappeared. I even thought he saw that animal on the road, and got scared and left. Anyway, what happened, is that before long, I saw a car coming down the road. The owner of the vehicle stopped next to my car, and this driver was the same guy that I had seen on the farm fence. He told us to get in his truck fast, and I realized that this guy was armed with a shotgun. Finally, we did this, and me and my family got into the farmer's vehicle. This man said that he woke up with the sounds of my car horn and came to see what was happening on the street, and when he got close to the fence, the farmer saw this creature hiding behind a tree, but that beast was standing, like a man, only on two legs, and watching my car. At first, he even thought it was a man, but later, he saw that that figure was a bizarre creature, with big ears and hairy, and also its eyes were lit, and for the farmer it was a werewolf. The fact is, that really that strange animal, I had never seen anything like it in my life, and also, by the lighted eyes that it had, it certainly was a werewolf, but I had only seen it walking on four legs. So, with all this, the old man was worried to see us on the road surrounded by this monster, and so he came with his car to get us out of danger. Anyway, I left my car on the road, and we went together with this driver to his farm, and arriving there, my wife and my son went to sleep in one of the rooms of the house, and I stayed awake with this farmer, and talking to him about the werewolf. However, this bumpkin told me that his horse had been attacked by some ferocious animal at dawn, and on those days his animal seemed to be very frightened by something. But what happened, is that a certain day, a strange guy in the late afternoon passed near his farm, but this injured horse began to get nervous with this guy, and the horse began to follow the suspect through the fence, and it seemed that the animal was very angry with this guy, and if it were not for the wire fence of the farm, the horse would have attacked this strange man. The farmer said that he had not seen anything like this in his whole life, of a horse acting like this against a human being, but the farmer was suspicious of this man, who could be the werewolf that appeared on the road, and tried to attack my car. And that night, the farmer's horse was just as nervous, and looking all around the fence, wanting to warn him of something. The farmer thought it was the strange guy, walking around the place again, and at this time, I made noises with the horn, and this bumpkin saw us on the road, surrounded by the werewolf. I can't really say that it was a werewolf, because I only saw it on four legs, but it was a bizarre and dangerous creature. However, in this story of terror that I lived in this early morning, did not take long, and soon the day came, and then, the guy from the farm helped me to fix my car, and then, I went away to my house in the city. And thinking about this whole story, my conclusion, is that the werewolf is that attacked and injured the horse, but the animal tried to attack the man suspected of being the werewolf. But in this whole story, the fear I got until today, is that when I pass some place in the woods at night, I already remember this beast. Good guys, thanks for watching the video, and if you like, leave your like and subscribe to the channel Fear Zone, until the next horror video.
Fear Zone, your horror channel. Good evening everyone, and today's report is from Caesar, who lives in a region near the city of Piracicaba, which is in Brazil, and this event was in the year 1994, when he was 18 years old. And the story that I am going to tell you was something unforgettable that I went through in my life. And it all started like this. I lived with my family in a kind of small farm, and my father had his pig and chicken farms. One dawn I heard some strange howling, and those sounds came from far away, but they were pretty scary too. With all that sound that this animal was making, my dogs were barking and howling too, but I looked out the window of my room and looked into the woods near the fence of my farm, but it was very dark there and we could see almost nothing, so I let it go and ended up sleeping. When the day dawned, I went outside the house and saw my father looking at his farms where something had taken two of our chickens. He asked me if I had seen anything at dawn, and I said that I hadn't seen anything, but that I had only heard a kind of howl from some animal that might be in the woods or prowling around near our farm. At that moment, my father became suspicious and grabbed his rifle, and we made a round through the bushes to see if we could find the animal, and as it was morning and day, it would be easier to find the animal that might have taken our chickens. We started walking through the bushes and saw one of our dead chickens on the way, and this was a clue that it had been an animal that had done this, because the chicken had been eaten alive, but only the carcass of the bird was left. We continued walking around the place, and we got close to an abandoned train line that was nearby, and just ahead we saw a tunnel where this train line used to pass, but the place had been deactivated for years because it was very old. We entered inside this tunnel. Even though it was daytime, it was very dark there, but on the walls of this tunnel, there were some strange drawings that looked like symbols, and for sure it was a wizard that made those symbols. Then we returned to our farm, and my father told me that if I heard this animal howl again, I should tell him. And after this episode of the animal, which we were looking for a few days, everything seemed to go back to normal, until one night, I woke up with the barking of my dogs, and when I got out of bed to look, I heard some shotgun shots, and sure enough, it was my father who shot something. Then my father came into the house with the rifle in his hands. He called me to go after the animal together. My father went to the backyard, and he started his truck, and with the car we would get there faster in the tunnel, because he thought that the animal he saw on our farm was hiding in that place. So we walked along the dirt roads of the region until we got to the train tracks near the tunnel, and we stopped the truck there, and we got out of the vehicle. My father turned on his flashlight, and we started walking in the middle of the forest, and it was about 2 o'clock in the morning, and when we got to the train tracks, we saw a strange thing inside the tunnel, where it could be the hiding place of the animal we were looking for, because there was a fire burning inside. So, we entered this tunnel to investigate, and near the fire, we saw some clothes lying on the ground. We found them strange, because they were good clothes, but it didn't take long, and we heard a noise in the bushes near us, and we decided to hide in some bushes inside this tunnel. Soon we saw a strange thing at the entrance of this tunnel, because there was something walking through the woods near where we were, because it seemed to be a figure standing, like a man. At this moment we turned off the lights of the lanterns, but by the brightness of the fire we could see a little the tunnel entrance. But at that moment, my father took his rifle and kept looking in the direction of that black figure, but when that figure arrived at the entrance of the tunnel, we saw that it wasn't a man, because it seemed to be a weird thing, but it was a very terrifying moment, and that creature was looking into the tunnel, and it seemed to be a dog the size of a man, and it was standing up, as if it was a person, and its eyes were very yellowish as if they were lit. But my father told us not to make any noise, because he wouldn't take it out on that strange creature, unless it saw us hiding in there, and the werewolf kept looking into the tunnel, and didn't want to go in there, and at that time it was like sniffing the air, and with that, I got a little scared, because it seemed that the werewolf smelled us in there, and the werewolf's reaction was not to go inside the tunnel, and it ended up disappearing from our sight. We were very scared, and soon we realized that that monster was hiding somewhere near the entrance to the side of the tunnel. That werewolf was growling in our direction, and for sure he was surrounding us to try to terrorize us, and that's when that creature got up from the bushes, and stood up again, and trying to find us inside, but my father and I, we were well hidden behind some bushes that were there inside that tunnel, and I felt surrounded by that creature. But that werewolf stood on four legs, and when he went to walk into the tunnel, he fell to the ground as if he was hurt. That creature got up and tried to stand on four legs, and tried to walk again, but this beast was limping, and his front legs were hurt, and this creature was growling in pain. Me and my father took advantage of this problem of the werewolf, and we fled this place running. Anyway, we got to our truck that was parked on the road, and we left the place. We came back to our farm very scared, and so we closed all the doors and windows of the house, and stayed there very scared, because we had gone through something unexplainable, and we were smart, with any movement or noise near the farm, because this werewolf could still come back to our residence to get our chickens. But after this occurrence, the days went by, and everyone in my family was forbidden to go out at night in the backyard of our house, because that werewolf could be prowling around the place, and also that beast could come back for revenge, because my father thought that he was the one who shot the werewolf in the leg. After almost a month had passed since we saw the creature, my father said that he passed by during the day near the werewolf tunnel, and there he saw a man that dealt with witchcraft. My father asked this witch if he knew anything about any creature that appeared in this tunnel of the railway line. The wizard said that a strange man sometimes came at night and stayed in this tunnel at dawn, and that this strange guy drew those symbols on the tunnel walls, and that for sure the suspect was a wizard too, but that this stranger must have been working with magic beyond what was allowed, and that the suspect could even change his human form, judge the wizard by the types of symbols drawn in the tunnel. but the wizard said that the man suspected in the tunnel, someone shot him in the arm, and to this day he has not appeared in the neighborhood. After this conversation, my father left this place, thinking that he had hurt that werewolf. Anyway, I didn't know if other people saw this werewolf, but my fear to this day is that this werewolf comes back for revenge, and it may be that there are more creatures like these out there that stay hidden in the woods at dawn, and also, I was afraid at that time of my father getting involved in the story of the wounded wizard, because the clues show that the wizard of the tunnel was the creature. Good guys, that was my horror story. Good night. If you liked the video, give a like and subscribe. Until the next werewolf story. Fear Zone, your horror channel. Well, before you start, subscribe to the channel and leave your like to receive more reports of the channel. Now then, let's go to the story of today. My name Benedict. This story happened to me in the year 2002 in the city of Poços de Caldas, which is in Brazil, and at that time I was 26 years old. To begin my story, a few years ago I lived in an ordinary village in my city, but near my neighborhood there were many woods and vacant lots. Anyway, at that time I also started dating a woman from a nearby neighborhood, and to get to her house I had to go through some dirt roads. One night, I was at my girlfriend's house, and a few hours passed, and I decided to leave for my house, so I started walking along a dirt road, and soon passed by a small farm, where this place was for sale, and there was no one living in this place, and there were several fruit trees. As there was no one living in this place, I decided to enter this farm to get some oranges. However, I saw an avocado tree, and I went there to get these fruits, which was near the house inside the farm, but soon the light of this house turned on. At that moment I thought of leaving this small farm, and was that suddenly, I started to hear some dogs barking, and at that time a walker came running out from inside this house, and he warned me to run, and told me, run, because there is a strange creature inside that old house. Well, at that moment I was going to run out of that place too, and when I looked back the walker was already leaving the place running, but his dog still stayed there barking near the abandoned house, and it was for something strange. I could see quickly that it was two dogs, and for sure those dogs were the walker's dogs. But to my amazement, I saw coming out from behind the old house a huge creature, and as it was very dark there, I couldn't identify what animal it was, but the two dogs of the walker surrounded this strange beast. But what caught my attention was the glow that this creature had in its eyes, which were lit yellow. But as the creature saw me, it started to run towards me, and I ran too. And in that moment of danger, I jumped over the fence of the farm and fell to the ground. But as soon as I got up from the ground, I looked at that creature and was surprised at what I saw, for the strange animal was standing near the fence, balancing on two legs, and he was trying to pass through the fence to come after me. But to my luck, the dogs of the walker surrounded this werewolf and would not let him pass through the fence, for the dogs barked and also threatened to attack this creature. At this moment, I caught my breath and ran out of this place and soon arrived at my house. But I was very scared, because I didn't even sleep that day, and I was afraid that this strange creature had followed me, and any noise on the street, I was already on alert, and spent the whole night like that. But when the day came, I was scared and thinking about this dangerous creature. But a week passed, and I was calmer about this experience that I went through with this strange animal, that to me, was a werewolf. But one thing too, is that I wanted to know about that wanderer that ran away from the werewolf that day in the farm. I kept looking for this man in my neighborhood for a few days to see if I would have more information about this creature and why, how this beast appeared in that farm. But a few weeks passed until I found this walker and started talking to him, and asked if he remembered me in that abandoned place and the appearance of that creature that seemed to be half man, half animal. Then the walker told the story of that night. He said that a new homeless man arrived in town, and this stranger, he had nowhere to spend the night, that the walker wanted to take him to a hostel in the city to sleep. But this strange man said he didn't like to sleep in hostels, and that he wouldn't go there at all. So the rover knew the abandoned farm, and as there were some houses there, he left the suspicious man there, and the rover walked to the hostel. But on the way, the rover found some money on the ground, and then he bought a bottle of kachaka, and as it was forbidden to enter the hostel with kachaka, the rover decided to return to the farm to sleep. But when he arrived at the small farm, he saw his new friend's clothes on the floor, and he thought it strange, and didn't see his friend around the place. Even so, when he was going to sleep, he heard his dogs barking near the abandoned house, so he turned on the light to see what was happening, because it could be his friend. But what he saw was this strange creature, and luckily his dogs surrounded that werewolf, and that's why the wanderer managed to escape, and also he saw me in that place and told me to run away too. After that day, he never saw this suspect again in the area, and I told the rover that if this strange man showed up, he should let me know. So, after that, I left for my house, and I kept thinking and relating this new street dweller that had appeared in town, that he was suspected of being the werewolf, because this story was a little strange to me, of the rover finding the clothes of the suspect man where we saw the werewolf. The fact is, I didn't see the creature again, and after a few days, I met this beggar from the abandoned farm again, and asked him if he had seen that street dweller again, or if he had seen that creature from the farm again. The beggar said that he didn't see any sign of this man, that he went with him to a farm, but the walker soon revealed to me what I already knew, because he claimed that the creature from the abandoned farm was a werewolf, because he saw that the animal stood like a man and had a head like a dog's. And after that day the creature appeared, the beggar never slept in the countryside again, for fear of meeting this animal again, and he went to the hostel. And thankfully, the dogs of the homeless man were okay, because they helped me escape from the creature at that critical moment near the fence. And now, thinking about this horror story, maybe that homeless man, who arrived new in town, for sure was the werewolf. Well, and that was my story. Good night. Well, if you liked the story, like the video, and subscribe to our Fear Zone channel. Until the next video, good night.